Hello everyone, how are you all doing? Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. It's me, Attorney Hani, and today we will have an online discussion on the Law and Partnership Chapter 1 Study Guide for Students. I actually made a video via YouTube on this, but for some reason, the background music was deleted or omitted by YouTube, maybe because of copyright issues. Nung pinost ko po kasi yung video na yun, no, I'm talking in Tagalog now. When I posted that last year, kasi hindi ko napansin yung copyright concern sa background music. Pero ngayon, nagkaroon na ng issue sa background music niya. So, maybe that's the reason why we don't have the background music. For those students na nakapanood na ng video na ito, sabi nila, okay lang naman na naka-follow naman daw sila. But sa ako mga estudyante sa Bukidnon State University now, medyo paspas daw. If you want to view the video, katong study guide, without me talking, without the voiceover now, you just click on the link, pangita lang, click somewhere there, pangita ang kuan ka ng yahang link or the video, click, click, click. So, yun yun ang tarawan dito ang yung study guide. So, maka-follow na mo, dayon, mayo. Kung ganaan mo pahinayon ang kanang yahang paste, you just click on the three buttons, makita na siya sa inyong screen, sa inyong mobile phone. Click na ninyo ang tulo ka button sa upper right corner of your screen and then click on that. Then you will see the playback speed. Ang playback speed, makapili ka og 0.75x, 0.5x o 0.25x. If you're using laptop, you just look for the settings sa video somewhere, sa video, click on that, then mugawas po ng playback speed. So, ang first yun yung makita ninyo nga naka-check dira is ang normal. Mamang yun normal. Kung ganaan mo ka-abnormal, kung ganaan mo ka-abnormal, kaya ganaan nyo ipahinay, just click katong 0.75, 0.5, or 0.25. Kung ganaan kagpaspas, kay bright kayo ka, pwede man na nimong papaspason. Pero kung ganahan ka, if you want to listen or view discussions on the Law and Partnerships Chapter 1 in English, straight English, kaya dili ka ganag binisaya, kaya social ka, pangita na lang somewhere there is a YouTube because naagid na. Okay, naagid na siya, gidiscuss sa mga maayog pagkita na itong mga abogado in straight English, comprehensive pa. But if you want it in Bisaya, nga kaning video, gamito na to, then you just keep on watching. So, kani siya mo ni ato ang study guide. So, ato ang discussion karon kay sa chapter 1 sa Law on Partnerships. No, wala na ni background music, ay magkabala ka, di na mo ma-stress. Di na po ta ma-copyright ni YouTube. Okay, kay magbinuotan ta, dili na ta mag-background music. Paminaw lang mo, pamati lang mo, okay? So, Partnership General Provisions. Now, when you look at the law, any law, for example, tanawon gyud na nimo ang general provisions. Ngano man, at least makakuha na kag idea unsa nang balaod about. So kani siya tong gamiton is ang New Civil Code of the Philippines, Title 9. Of course, Philippines man ta, no? So nasa Philippines. So Title 9 covering Articles 1767 to 1783. Pero sa ato karon atong i-discuss is kaning Chapter 1 lang sa. The reference material that I used was Hector de Leon's book og napoy mga reviewers nga makita ninyo all over the internet. And then sa ako mga estudyante karon sa Bukidnon State University adto Bihid campus, I uploaded a reference material, actually it's a reviewer on the Law and Partnership sa ato ang official Google Classroom. Turo ka buka tong Google Classroom, so inyo lang tanaw dito kung asa mo estudyante nako. So if you haven't joined the Google Classroom, join na, okay? So, ato na ta sa first article sa ato ang chapter 1. So, article 1767. Now, keywords. Nay keywords ma, unsa na? When I was still studying law, dili ko particular sa keywords. But then when I took up the bar sa during the self-review sessions nako, I realized nga very important din yung keywords. Why? Kani day mga keywords lang makakuha na kag idea what that legal provision is about. Dili na nanimo kailangan i-memorize kasi noon ang ginagawa ko dahil dyslexic ako, minememorize ko ang legal provisions, which is actually wrong. Pero tungod sa dyslexic mag ko, maglisod kong sabot, one pass lang sa pagbasa, maglisod kong sabot, so gimemorize na ko. Dapat kaya kung himuon di ay as a law student, na lost jud ko before, na lost student jud ko. Kay wala man ako gita ng keywords. Now, I knew better. Kay nga naman sab mga langga, kani pong mga examiners manggod nato sa bar manggod. If you are the type nga mag-take pag bar, no, barrister ka or bar examinee ka, ang kaniya tong mga bar examiners, no? Correct me if I'm wrong. Ang mga bar examiners na to, ilag yung ginapangita gyud, no? Sa kadaghan ba naman na ilang ginabasa ang keywords. Sa unang panahon, napakuinudunggan nga ang mga examiners, basta makita lang nilang keywords sa imuhang booklet, kaysa una, booklet man itong among gamit, no? Dili naman good booklet karon kay online naman good, social na, tungod po ani ni COVID, yeah. So, kato siya sa unang panahon, sa among panahon, murag pag, kuan ka rabit ang murag, tigong na yun kay kong feeling. Tigong lang naman yun ko. So, sa among panahon, sa booklet pa among gamit, keywords lang, makita sa examiner, okay na, pites na nga naman, sa 7,000 ba naman nga bar examinees ngayang chikan, wala na siya time nga basaw na niya tagsa. Yan ang tanawon o na netumbok, ana na siya keywords. Bahala pag dili na to ka-perfect ang yahang in English. Okay? So, by the contract of partnership, this is Article 1767, two or more persons bind themselves to contribute unsa, money, property, industry, asa man nila i-contribute sa common fund. Okay? So, balik taning contract, word nga contract. Kaning contract gani, unsa man? Kaning contract natay essential requisites. Ani? Ang contract, kailangan ba na siya in writing? The answer is no. Kaya namang giuban mo suti nga, ma'am, nagmugna mig among partnership. Unya, kay wala man na mo ito gisuwat, dili to siya valid. No. For the validity of any contract, it need not be in writing. It could be verbal as long as it actually has the three essential requisites. And what are the three essential requisites? First is, of course, the consent of the parties, no? Then second is the object and the consideration. Basta na lang tong tulo, okay na, contract na. Pero as to enforceability, of course, mulahin na po na nga istorya. Pero validity man na itong istorya, so as long as na itong tulo, dili na kailangan nga in writing, okay? So partnership, at least two persons, no? They bind themselves to contribute kaning either the money, property or industry. Kaning industry, mo ba ni siya ang ginasuti nga Department of Trade and Industry? Dili po. Okay? Kaya ahin siya man to sa gobyerno. Basta mo suti ba kag industry, kay mo magunay mo hago. Imong labor. Now, the labor that we're talking here is not the same as the labor nga laborer. Ha nga. Hindi ko anjun mo. Ang kanang industry na isi mong servisyong ihatag ni mo sa common fund sa inyohang partnership. Ang inyohang intention, kamo nga mga partners, ka inyong intention to divide the profits among yourselves. Another definition of partnership, manggod, mga langga, is this one. Kaning mga tao nga nakapasar sa board exams, kana sila ang mga lisensyado na to, ng mga profesional. So, kana sila, maggrupo-grupo na sila, okay, maggrupo-grupo na sila to form a partnership, okay, na, to form a partnership for the exercise of their profession. Na, yubo ko, wala ko'y COVID. Okay. So, kani magung bamboo bitaw, bugoy kaning bamboo. And then, natay word during a partnership. Okay, partnership, partner plus ship. Okay, dua ka buka words, partner plus ship. What is meant by partner? Partner is one of two people. And then ship, it's a body of persons who are participating in a specified activity. What is this activity? The activity is business. And the business involving contribution of money, property, or industry. And then we have here, pag masuti ka partnership, at least two or more persons lagi, ug ang tumong nila kay unsa man to divide the profits among themselves. So again, this is the definition of our contract of partnership. This is Article 1767. Let's proceed. Adto na punta sa kini ang characteristics of partnership. Now, we have seven characteristics of partnership. Let's discuss the first characteristic. And the first characteristic is consensual. From the root word, consent. Okay? Now, partnership is perfected by mere consent. Mao na akong gisulti na it need not be in writing. It could be verbal as long as may consent sa mga parties. The second characteristic is principal. Now, this is not the principal nga imo ang makita sa inyong eskwelahan sa grade school. Principal, meaning to say that the contract of partnership can actually stand alone and you don't need another contract for it to be valid. The third characteristic is it is nominate. Kani mo suti kag nominate, dili na siya mao kanang imonggi, I nominate Miss Chorba-Chorba to be the president of our class. No, dili na siya mao, okay? Basta mo suti kag nominate, meaning to say, nay pangalan. It has a designated name. And the designated name is partnership. The fourth characteristic is that it is commutative. When you say commutative, kanang mga partners, no? Kanang mga partners, anang contract of partnership, their contribution is equivalent to the contribution of the others. So if my contribution is 1 million, halimbawa, ako isa ka-partner, nga yung gisulti, ang yahadaw i-contribute, yung gi-promise, nga yung i-contribute sa among contract of partnership, kayang servisyo, dapat yung servisyo is equivalent to 1 million. Okay? Dili pwede nga masulti siya, naka-render naman ko pila ka-adlaw, yun na yun yung contribution ko. No. The labor or the service that you have to contribute to the common fund of the partnership must be equivalent to 1 million para makonsider yun ka nga partner. Okay? Kay unfair man po. Kay you derive the profits and you divide the profits among yourselves, ba? Nya, ang imuhang gi-contribute kay dili magyud siya mo commensurate dito sa contribution sa imong kauban. So, unfair po. So, the fifth characteristic of partnership is it is preparatory. Mamingon ka ngang kwan, kanang partnership kay it can stand alone, principal. Yes, it is principal but it is actually for the validity lang nga concern. Kaning preparatory, meaning to say, nga kani sila mag-partner ta, okay, maghimo tag itong contact of partnership, nga later on, maghimo na po tag another contact for our venture. Kaya pwede man good, nga ako, na ako'y laing negosyo, then nag-partner-partner lang ta, dili man necessary nga tied na yukay ko dito sa atong partnership. Kaya pwede man good, nga akong i-contribute money lang. Unless ang imo i-contribute kay imuhang serbisyo jud nga kung saan char nagtagalog nako kung saan nga imong serbisyo jud 100% imo gyud itutukyo dito sa imong partnership, ha, sa imong partnership. So there could be some instances that you need this contract of partnership so that you would execute another contract nga magkaroon ulit kayo ng ibang business venture. For example, partner ta and then magkaroon tayo ng joint venture later on sa mining or construction business, etc. The sixth characteristic is that it is non-onerous. Sa bagayong background, no? So, it is onerous. So, this is not pronounced as onerous. It is onerous in that the partners are burdened. Burdened sila to contribute to the common fund. Kay, siyempre, mapugus jug ka ba contribute? Dili nga, sulti ka nga partner ka, relax lang ka, no? Dili ka pwede mag-relax, dili na kuha na, okay rin. No, kailangan jud nga kung sa tayo magsulti nga imo i-contribute, imo gito ihatag. Kay mao man to siyang imo hangi promise lang ga. Kay burdened lagi ka mo. So, mao na siyang onerous. And then the last characteristic, and of course not the least, is it is bilateral or multilateral. Now, what is this bilateral or multilateral? It is not pronounced as bilateral, ha? It's bilateral. Ito nga pagka-pronounce ang bilateral. So, it involves two or more persons. Mao na siya nga bilateral or multilateral. Okay, so next, we have these essential elements of partnership. It is a valid contract, okay, and it involves two or more persons with legal capacity to enter into contract, mutual contribution, that is money, property, industry, by partners. And of course, the intention of the parties is to engage in lawful business, trade, or profession. So, kato, upat, kabok, triangle. Ang uban nga mga authors, na sila lain pa mga essential elements of partnership, but I actually like this one kay dali lang na kumabutang sa akong utok. So, basta makita ni mo ning valid contract, okay, valid contract, natong tulog kabuok. Sa akong contract, ma'am, it need not be in writing, it could be verbal. Basta na lang itong tulog, consent, object, or consideration, valid, okay, and then two or more persons with legal capacity to enter into contract because na may ibang tao nga gusto sila mag-partnership kunuhay, pero they are not capacitated to do so. Nga naman kay because, halimbawa, kanang bata pa ka siya because of minority or maybe it's because deaf mute siya, dili siya kapasa, dili siya kakita kadungog or dili siya makapacitate you to enter into any contract. So dili to sila pwede maka-appeal aning contract of partnership. Di sila pwede mahimong party sa contract of partnership. So ang kani ilang contribution must be either money, property or industry. So ila na ibutang sa ilahang common fund. And then of course the intention is to engage in lawful. Okay, again, lawful. Unsa ning lawful is dili siya illegal nga mga negosyo or profession kuno hay kay kung illegal gani ni siya unlawful dili gyud na siya pwede gyud nga matawag nga valid maayo nga partnership. Kailangan lawful jud kay ang uban magud nga mga tao maghimo sila ilang partnership para mang scam dili pud na maayo. Okay, so ang ilang purpose ani is actually to derive profits, obtain profits, and divide profits among themselves. Okay, now we have this term, delictus personae. What is this delictus personae? This is not pronounced as delictus personae, delictus personae. This is a Latin term which means choice of persons. You have the choice, no? As a partner, I have the right to choose or select with whom I want to be associated with in the partnership. Dili man necessary nga, uy, musulti yung sa katao nga, uy, Miss Kwan, ay attorney, maghibo man kag imong negosyo, di ba, kay private practitioner ka man, uy, nakuy amiga ba niya, gwapa ni siya, niya bright, kwan yun siya, i-appeal siya sa inyong partnership, be, no, dili ko mapugos ngayon, ana, because I have the right to choose or select with whom I want to be associated with. Dili na pugsanay ang contract of partnership. Kaya basi na ibang tao. So, tinga, gibutan ko nila sa contract of partnership. Di man gikuganan na to. Gipugos ko nila. Wala man ipugsanay. Nagyukay right na mo decline. Napugkay right to choose. Okay? Okay. Marapug na yung matubag. 1768. Partnership has a juridical personality separate and distinct from the partners or the partnership. Okay? So, saan niya siya pag-illustrate? Okay, we will illustrate here. Partnership in itself is a juridical person which is separate and distinct from the partners composing such partnership. So it has the capacity to act on its own. Katong ilang partnership. But of course, datong mga tao, nga mao sila maglihok yun sa partnership. So if A og B og C ni form sila og ilang partnership, D partnership, so naay upat ka buo ka tao involved or characters or persons involved. In this case, si partner A, partner B, partner C, og si D partnership. Now, all of these persons, si A, B, C, og D, they are separate and distinct from each other. So, katong si partnership D, dili na siya equivalent to partner A only, or partner B only, or partner C only, or partner A plus B, or partner B plus C, dili, or partner A plus C. Ngano man, because D partnership is equivalent to A plus B plus C. Okay? So, kung wala gani ng isa sa ila, kung wala, limbawa, wala si A, or wala si B, or wala si C, kay si A og B lang, dili na pwede mga tawag na D partnership. Okay? So, kailangan na gina silang tulog yun ka partners para matawag na D partnership. Kaya mawag yun ang ilang gisugdan. Okay? So, next. 1768, tanaw na ito ni, even in case of failure to comply with the requirements of Article 72. Okay, Article 72. So, unsa man ni Article 72, ma'am? Okay, duha na to. So, every contract of partnership having a capital of 3,000 pesos. So, ang ilang capital gani, kaya wala magun nakabutan kung dapat pilagyud ang amount kay contribute. Wala, di ba? Kaya ang gisulti lang dito, contribute money, property, industry. Wala sila gisulti unsang amount. Okay, so ang gisulti na ni sa 1772, basta gani ang contract of partnership gani nga ang ilhang capital kay 3,000 pesos or more in property or money, dapat notarized ang ilhang contract of partnership. For example, partnership, by example, blah 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 partnership, then ang pangalan dito, sa ilang gi-contribute kay equivalent to 3,000 plus more. So, if the amount involved in the contract kaya ng ilang gi-contribute, more than 3,000 pesos, dapat ma-notarize ang ilahang contract of partnership. Of course, dili na nimo ma-notarize kung dili written. So, dapat in writing. And the same document must be recorded in the office of the SEC or the Securities and Exchange Commission. So, mabalik ta dito, nga naman siya ni gawas man siya nga article, ma'am, or legal provision. Kaya, nakabutang manggudinhi, partnership has a juridical personality separate and distinct from that each of the partners. Even in case of failure to comply, sa kailangan kasi nga mu-comply sila sa requirement 1772. So, unsa ni siya pag-apply, ma'am? Limbawa, kaning si A, B, C, og D, di ba? A, B, C, og D, ilang partnership, ang pangalan kay D partnership. Ang amount sa ilahang gi-contribute kay more than 3,000, let's say 5,000 pesos ang ilang total contribution. Daw bi kay wala man sila nag-add to sa wala man nila gi-notarize ang ilahang contract of partnership tapos wala po nila na register sa SEC. So meaning to say ba ana ma'am, kay dili separate ang ilahang personality from each other kay wala man nila na comply tong requirements sa 1772 dili separate and distinct from each other gihapon sila. So kung wala nila gibutang dito sa ilahang common fund, ang katong 2000 pesos or katong laptop ni letter A halimbawa, dili to siya pwede nga masuti kag amo na lang ng kuhaon ni mong laptop kay wala man mi ka comply aning requirements sa article 1772. So wala man mi ani, wa man mi ka kuan sa sexo. Kuan ka nang dili na siya separate and distinct from the partners ang kaning amo ang partnership. So nagiapon mi right no. Even if they were not able to comply with this requirement, separate and distinct gihapon sila sa isa't isa. So partner A, partner B, partner C, partner D gihapon sila. Okay? Or the partnership gihapon sila. Next, the next ha. Mahapit na ni. So, non-registration na siya dali, oh. Non-registration of the contract of partnership with the SEC will not invalidate it. As long as the essential elements are present, such contract of partnership is valid and would still have a juridical personality separate and distinct from the partners. Okay, the only purpose of registration. So, nga naman to siya, mga nakal, ma'am, nga nung kailangan mag-git na siya i-register sa SEC, ma'am? Uy, nga 3,000 pesos, raman kayo siya. 3,000, 4,000 pesos, raman kayo siya, ma'am. Uy, the purpose of registration is actually to give notice to third persons so that the partners involved cannot feign ignorance to the contract of partnership simply because it was not registered with the SEC, since they themselves knew of the contents of their contract. So, dili po ni sila maka-feign ignorance. Kaya na mag-ibang tao nga mo, kuwan man good sila, mo kipagkontrata sila sa inyong partnership. Kaya bitang, karaman limbong bitang, ah, kuwan mi, kanang nami legal personality, kay nakakuan mi, kaya bitang, sa ito gani, nami contract of partnership, ananay, pakita din yung sekundin, dili man ako ni kuwan, dili na ako ni bulsa imong kwarta, then, bam, scam dito siya, then, so, dito, ah, wala man ilabot, kay separate and distinct, man, dili mi, kuwan, kaya bitang, wala ko ilabot, ana, wala ka. No, you cannot feign ignorance anymore to the contract of partnership, even if it was not registered with. Wala man mina-register sa SEC. Kato siya among contract of partnership kay amo-amo raman to. Dili ka makasutian nga inyo-inyo lang, wala nyo gi-register sa SEC. So, pwede na lugar mo makakuan, makalayas na lugar, wala mo ilabot, ana, dili, pwede. Kaya again, ato lagyud aning ginahimo sa tanan atong transactions dinhi sa kalibutan. Everything must be done in good faith, dapat good juda sa atong kapwa. Ana gyud siya. Okay, so dili kita pwede magsuti nga wala man mi kabaluan na mag-feign ignorance and ignorance of the law excuses no one from compliance therewith. Ayan. So we have here effects of separate juridical personality and partnership. So the first effect of separate and juridical personality of partnership is that it can incur obligation or it can enter into contract. Mao na siya kay ang mga ubang tao gusto na sila dili sila ganang single proprietorship kanang isa ra ka tao gusto nila magkuan sila kanang mo kuan sila more than two, so mao na siya partnership. So it can incur obligation or it can enter into contract. So it can sue or be sued. Okay, so that's why it's called separate and juridical personality. It can sue or be sued. Pwede siya mag file a complaint or mag file siya og sumbong or pwede po siya filean og complaint. Pero dili man necessary nga kuan siya kanabitong kailangan jud nga ang kuan jud kada isa ra ka tao, pwede na, no, ang katugyong partnership. And then it can be adjudged as insolvent even if the partners are solvent. Okay. So halimbawa ilang partnership, no, sa ilang partnership kay naa sila gi kuan na contribute to silang money, property, industry ana, then bigla nga halimbawa lang ha, na bankrupt lugar sila ilang partnership. So muso din nga dili man na nimo pwede nga matawag nga bankrupt kay ang mga tao man na kay dato man na sila naman na sila kwarta, no, it can be adjudged as insolvent kay separate man siya, lahi man tong partnership kay it can stand alone gani, it can stand alone. So pwede gid na siya ma-adjudge o pwede siya masulti nga insolvent ang ilang partnership kay total kana siya. If ang partnership i-adjudge as insolvent, negative naman po na siya ang iyahang bearing dito sa mga tao kanang pagiging insolvent, even if the partners are solvent, okay? Then death of any of the partners would not warrant the dismissal of the case against the partnership. So, hala, na kaso against your partnership, the partnership, kaya nag-scam lagi. Scam lagi si the partnership. Ay, dismissal ni dapat judge, kaya namatay manggod ang hamo si Kwan, si partner B. No, dili na siya pwede kay katumanggod si partner B, separate personality man siya from the partnership. Ni stand gyapon ang inyuhang partnership. Okay? So, kana siya is kanang musulti mo nga, hala, di ba yung gisulti kay kuan kanang this is equivalent to A plus B plus C. Yes, pero nag-start naman tong case niya na to. Tapos, nagkuhan naman siya kanang lahi. Mag-ito siya ang personality yun sa inyong partnership, yun sa inyong kapwa sa kuan, sa inyong katagsa-tagsa, di ba? So, mauna siya nga, it cannot warrant the dismissal of the case against the partnership. Dili siya pwede nga, i-dissolve na din. So, okay, namatay siya. So, dismiss. Dili. Muagig na siya og process. And then the fifth effect of separate and juridical personality of partnership is that it can possess and acquire property of all kinds. So, kanang halimbawa, imong property nga imong gi-contribute sa common fund sa partnership, basta for example, ang imuhang balay, anak, dapat na kay title jud nga imong yung gi-transfer jud ang name dito sa partnership. Otherwise, wala gito niya imo siya na-contribute jud sa inyohang partnership. And then we have number six, the sixth effect is that summons upon the managing partner will bind the partnership. So halimbawa, managing partner dito lang nahatag sa iya katong summon, no? Katong summon. So ang katong managing partner musulti siya, ako ra may naka-receive, musulti ang katong inyong kauban. Uy, wala oy, dili mo bind kay wala man mi naka-receive, no? Kay ang managing partner man ang naka-receive for and in behalf of the partnership. So kwan gyud siya kanabitong appeal gyud ang partnership gyud as if naka-receive atong summons. Okay? So, that's the effect of separate juridical personality of partnership. So, kana siya mga tao nga kuan appeal sa partnership kay dili gina sila maka-feign ignorance halimbawa sa ilang mga nahimo sa ilang partnership kay kuan magud sila kanang ila man nang gi-deem nagyapon na sila nga ilang act as a group nga nagba ka ABC A plus B plus C is equivalent to D. So, dili ito man sa person. Wala man ko ilabot. He has to prove. No, he has the burden of proof to say nga, wala gid siya ilabot yun atong act halimbawa sa gihimo ni partnership. No, ni D partnership. Kaya, ang presume yun ani nga, ang gihimo yun ana sa partnership is, katong ilhang gihimo yun as A, B, plus C. Okay? A plus B plus C to siya nga act. Therefore, D partnership ang isumon or i-file ano kaso. So, it can be sued and it can also sue. Okay, as a partner. Okay, the next. And shot, ask it. 1769 is determination of the existence of partnership. How can we know, how would we know that the partnership exists? Okay, so mauna siya ang atong himuon. So in determining the existence of partnership, you have to check if the essential elements of partnership are present. So you have to focus on the following. Now by common fund, check. Yes, na common fund. Na by interest na joint interest sa mga tao sa profits. So, masulti kag yes. Na sila joint interest. Na may mutual benefits or advantage sa partners. Masulti kag yes. So, kasagaran ni basta ganina ni siya, check ni siya. So, nagyoy ni exist ng partnership. So, mao ni siya ang 1769. Okay. Except as provided by Article 1825. So, persons who are not partners as to each other are not partners as to a third person. So, basta gani, kaning third persons magod, mo ni siya ang atong gina-protektahan. Aning mga, inani nga klase nga mga partnership. Kaya pwede magod, nga limbung-limbungan ni mo ang third persons. So, din sila nga, wala man ko, kan man to, kanang mugna-mugna raman to among partnership. Napugos raman ko ato, di ba? Atong gisulting nga, ang partnership kay dili man na pwede nga gipugos ka because you have the right to choose. And you have the right to select who you want to be associated with in the partnership. So, dili ka maka-feign ignorance unless nga, grabe yung sa katanan na ilang gihimo para ilag yung pangilan nga gigamit yung imong name. Pero halimbawa, nag-yug ka, nag-sign jug ka, masulti ka, amang ko kabalo. You cannot say that, okay? So, pag ang kanin siya, Article 25 man God, as provided by Article 25, persons who are not partners as to each other, so basta masulti ko nga dili ko partner anak, so dili sila may mong partner sa katong mga third person. So, second is that co-ownership or co-position does not in itself establish a partnership. Kaya, for example, ka na mga igsoon, no? Namoy common nga balay, and then later, kay inyo nang ikuha, no? Halimbawa, masulti mo na, ay, naman may balay, commonly owned, so amo ni siyang ibaligya, halimbawa, then partners na may diritso, no? Dili na siya ingon, ana. Or, kanang kuan, kanang namoy isa ka property, ana, tapos bigla nga, kanik atong property kay naman tay stake ani so mahimong insigida automatic partners ta no whether such co-owners or co-possessors do or do not share any profits made by the use of the property. So it is not automatic, no, nga maka-establish tayo og partnership, because again, in partnership, you need the consent, no? The contracted consent of the partners among themselves that they really want to contribute such money, property, industry to the common fund, and the purpose is to derive profits and divide the profits among themselves. Memorize lang na. Or imo lang na sabton di, sorry. Imo lang na sabton din, okay ka na. Okay ka na. So, mao na siya inyong hinumdumon sa contract of partnership. And then the sharing of gross returns does not in itself establish a partnership. So, mao na siya inyong hinumdumon nga, ala, nakakuha ra ba ka sa amo, so partner na ta. No, whether or not the person sharing them have a joint or common right or interest in any form, any property from which the returns are derived. So, dili na siya in sigida lagi nga mahimo na dayon kang partner kay tungod sa nakakuha ko og kanang return or profit. Anang, for example, na may gibalik, may isoon mo, halimbawa niya, ang balay sa inyo hang ginikanan or kanang ang balay sa inyo hang lolog, lola, kay nayhalin, tapos nakaderive mo ang nag-profit atong halin sa atong balay nga gibaligya, then partner mo, no, dili mo na na. The receipt by a person of a share of the profits of a business is prima facie evidence that he is a partner in the business, but no such inference shall be drawn if the profits were received in payment. Tapos, in payment to nanay siya isumpay. Okay, so, kana siya, kaning receipt manggod is prima facie, no? Sa first palang matanong ni mo, pwede yun na siya nga partner ni siya kung naka-receive siya og profit sa negosyo. Pero ang kuna ni exception ani is mao ni sila. So lima ka buok. Okay? So as a debt, ang katungyang na receive kay as a debt. So bayad siya sa debt, no? By installments or otherwise, kanang bayad siya as weldo. Okay? As annuity to a widow, okay? Tapos as interest kung interest lang to siya sa loan, and then consideration by the sale of a goodwill. So mao na siya ang mga instances nga makasuti kang katong pag-receive niya sa payment kay dili siya prima facie evidence of being a partner to the partnership. Okay. So let's proceed to the next. Okay. So kani siya another illustration eh. If A and B are not partners, they are not deemed partners as to third persons. But when a person represents himself, so nagsuti siya nga, uy, or ni consent siya sa isa ka tao nga kuan partner siya sa kanang ni exist na nga partnership or with one or more persons na actually partners, liable na siya. Kaya nga naman, nalinlang niya kasi yung tao na paniwalaan siya na partner nga siya nung partnership na yun. Nag-Tagalog na ko. Was on the faith of such representation given credit to the actual or apparent partnership. So this is Article 1825 of the New Civil Code. So mao na siya nga dapat kita, dili ta magpataka-taka. So sige na, ingna lang gud nga partner ta sa partnership kay para masugot lang siya magpautang sa ako. So if A and B are not partners but B represents to C, so let's say C is a third person, that A and B are partners even if they are not really partners. So in the presence of A, okay, and A did not object, so to say, sige na lang. Then the law considers them A and B as partners, although in truth and in fact they are not actually partners. Okay. So, diri na ta. So, partnership must have a lawful object or purpose. Diba? So, tita, nga dapat jud in good faith ta, maayog kita o tumong jud sa tanang transactions na to. And it must be established for the common benefit or interest of the partners. So, when an unlawful partnership is dissolved, so unlawful siya, kay dili maayo ang ilahang purpose, no? By a judicial decree. So, ang profits ato nila, i-confiscate to siya in favor of the state. Yan naman. Kaya siyempre, unlawful, illegal nga ang kanilang partnership. So, padulong yun to siya sa state. Dili mo suti ang iyong asawang, ay, nakuha man to. Kanang, nakuha naman, na-dissolve man ang katong partnership sa akong bana. So, padulong sa amo. No. Padulong to siya sa state. So, kailangan yun na to yun nga. In everything that we do, everything must be in good faith and we should not do anything unlawful or illegal. So, without prejudice to the provisions of the penal code. Okay. So, kasagara ko na, crime, effects of the crime. 1771, Article 1771 provides that a partnership may be constituted in any form, okay? Except where immovable property. So halimbawa katuin yung hang, di ba, disultita ng ang partnership kay it need not be in writing, di ba? But if it actually involves immovable property, kay mauman na siya ang ilang i-contribute sa common fund sa partnership, so that immovable property katong pag-contribute niya, dapat it must be in writing. And it must be notarized. It must be a public instrument. So, necessary na siya kay immovable property man good. So, a contract of partnership is void whenever an immovable property is contributed thereto. If an inventory of said property is not made signed by the parties and attached to the public interest instrument. So, nagi specific form for immovable properties nga gi-contribute sa partnership. Okay. So, diri na ta sa coverage of statute of frauds. So, statute of frauds in partnership contract. So, kani siyang statute of frauds, mo ni siyang ginakuan nga kailangan in writing. Okay? Ang inyong transaction and sa inyong mga dealings, ana, it must be in writing. So, promise to answer for debt, default or miscarriage of another by a partnership. So, partners agree to form partnership 1 year later. Kaya na mag-iuban, musuti sila nga, uy, bay, mag-partnership na mag-form tag-partnership 1 year later. Na, kaya di ba itong isuti ang partnership? It need not be in writing, di ba? It could be verbal, it could be in writing. So, these are the instances when the partnership must be in writing because it is covered under the statute of fraud. So, unsa tong lima kabuok, kanang namoy promise nga inyo ang bayaran ng utang, no? Answer for debt, default, or miscarriage of another by partnership. Tapos, kato inyong agreement nga ang kato inyong partnership kay 1 year after pa ninyo himuon. Kato ang inyong contracts for sale of real property. Basta gani, immovable property, real property involved na gani sa if any contract, kailangan it must be in writing because it's covered under the statute of frauds. Kaya nga naman, kay kita magkong tao, dali na kayo takalimot. Na, dali kayo takalimot. Alam mo na kaning yuta, mga real property, immovable property, mga ga-appreciate na siyang value, no? Dako ang value. So, kailangan yun na siya in writing or ka ng mga 5,000, more than 5,000, no? Yeah, 500. So, ang kwanana is kailangan jud in writing. Yan. So, contracts for sale of real property, leasing of partnership property for more than 1 year. If the lease is for more than 1 year, it must be in writing. Sale of personal property at a price not less than 500 pesos. Unless there's already a delivery or payment. Kaya kung nanay delivery or payment, that is already. Kwanaman na na siya, kanang proof na na siya, nga naagyoy, inanagyod nga. Dealing or transaction. So, kailangan it must be in writing because it's covered under the statute of frauds. So, next, nanapunta din hi sa ato ang provision nga 1774. So, any immovable property or interest therein may be dahu kay siya gang. And any, asa man to siya? Dahu kayo. I have no idea why it happened like this. Property interest then may be acquired by partnership name. So, titles acquired can be conveyed to the partnership name. So, kung sa man tong, di ba, katong partnership kay separate juridical personality, di ba? So, kato siya, pwede siya makapalit og any property nga gamit ang iyang pangalan. Even if, even katong ganing imong i-contribute ng real property or immovable property sa common fund sa partnership, ang title ato kay matransfer na sa name sa partnership. So, it can acquire title na dayon ang kaning partnership. Okay, so next. Next time is 1775. Animated kasi ito. So, we have here mga keywords na po, articles governed by provisions relating to co-ownership. So, kanisya, associations and societies whose articles are kept secret among the members and wherein any one of the members may contract in his own name with third persons shall have no juridical personality and shall be governed by provisions relating to co-ownership. Kaya, ang uban man kun nga mga partners bitaw kay ilang itago bitaw nga ilang ibutang sa ilang name. Yeah, with third person. So, kapag ka ang third persons gani, no, whoever deals with anyone, yeah, kanang partnership, no, dapat ilag yung tanawon jud kinsa gitong mga partners jud o unsa gitong ilang kuan jud kinsa ilang kadil. Kaya naman kung uban nga mga members bitaw sa partnership, mga mandarambong, ila na ibutang dahil sa ilang pangalan dayon. So, tisag, ay, kaya ako mag managing partner, aning among partnership, ibutang sa akong name na lang. No, dili pwede, ha? Dili pwede. So, tisag, ako may naning kamot, ani, ako may nagkuan ani, nagpaayos ani, ako'y nag-take, kuan ani, nag-take good care ani nga property, ana. So, mag-govern na dayon ang co-ownership, katong mga provisions na din sa co-ownership if this happens. Okay. So, classifications of partnership. Even if katong, by the way, balik ta din, even if katong, kuan katong partner, siya pa ang nigastos yun, tanan-tanan, naningkamo yun ato. So, the provisions on co-ownership would apply. Okay, so, derita sa 1776. So, as to its object, a partnership is either universal or particular. So, as regards the liability of the partners, a partnership may be general or limited. So, maura na inyong hunaw-naw, universal, particular, limited, or general ang partnership. As regards their liability. So, Naman gud ni mga partnership nga musulti man gud nga kuan ka ng among liability kay dili gyud mo kuan ka ng among liability kay tanan-tanan na gyud, tanan-tanan na gyud sa among gyud, among na gyud ng liability gyud, kuan na gyud namo i-shoulder na namo tanan as partners. No, dai mga instances nga ang partner ang ilang liability sa partnership, sa mga loss, ang mga liability sa partnership kay limited lang siya, dili gyud pareha sa uban. Okay. So we have here classifications of partnership. So we have universal partnership and then we have particular partnership. Okay? And then as to liability, kani siya, mga kuan ni siya later ato man i-discuss taas sa mga kistanan. So ma-discuss ni siya one by one din ato. We have general partnership. All partners are liable to the extent of their separate property. So imagine, pati ka to ilang separate property, even if it was not contributed to the partnership, basta ganit general partnership, pati ka to malayable sila, so ma-appeal to siya. Limited partnership, at least one general partner, one limited partner, no? Liability of limited partner is only to the extent of his contribution. So kung sa man yang na-contribute, taman na po dito ang iyang liability kung na may mga losses ang partnership. As to duration at term, so the term of existence is unlimited. So weird kaya sa katanan yung ilang existence kaya unlimited sa ilang partnership. Kung fixed terms, of course, naka-indicate dito, 100 kanusa lang ang ilang partnership. Kaya pag-abot ato nga panahon, madissolve na dayon ang ilang partnership. So as to manner of creation, it is orally agreed upon by the parties, no? Orally lang siya, and then written, of course, in a public instrument. So it's notarized. We have here the following kinds of partner. So, kinds of partner we have according to liability. We have general partner versus limited partner. And then, katong limited partner, kay limited lang to the contribution, general partner. Pati katuyang separate nga property, ma-appeal siya sa pagbayad sa liability or pag-cover sa liability. Then we have nature of contribution to the partnership. We have capitalist partner versus industrial partner. Kani industrial partner, ang yarang ihatag is yung serbisyo sa partnership. And of course, yung serbisyo dapat buong-buo niyang ibibigay doon sa partnership. Okay. And then, yung capitalist partner, of course, mga na siya katong sa kwarta, no? So, as to the extent of participation in the business, so we have universal partner and particular partner. Kay limited ra iyang participation. As to his power in partnership management, we have the silent partner and the dominant partner. So, ganun siya actually, pang-discuss na siya later on sa ato ang partnership. Kaya ganun siya, sa kanapitang, in a nutshell, what is law and partnership? As to knowledge by the public, so we have ostensible partner versus secret partner. Ostensible, katong kabalo ang tanan. Nga kani siya, partner gid siya. Appeal siya sa partnership. Kaning secret partner, not known to the public, dili ni siya gina-kwan gud, gina-encourage yun, kaning mga secret partner. Although, nayuban, nga ilan ang ginahimo, kay para lagi daw, dili sila mataksan daw, dili daw sila makuan ay mga, uban pang ilang gina-likay-likayan. Mauna, ginatawag sila ng secret partner. Dili na siya, lahi na sa katong, mga secret-secret yung mga kabit-kabit, hala ito siya. As to connection with the partnership, we have real partner versus nominal partner. So, katong real partner versus partner by stop, kaya kato siya sangalan lang, no? Sangalan lang siya, partner-partner. Pero, stop na siya nga musulti. I meaning to stop is, dili na ka makasulti bitong nga, murag barb na ka ba? Dili na ka pwede makasulting, ay, dili mang yung kutinod nga partner. Kaya pang partner-partner naman ko sa pangalan na. As to third persons, kaya tungod sa nisalig siya nga ikaw, partner yung ka ana nga partnership, so, mahimo na yung kang partner. Okay, so magiging liable ka na. So we have 1778, Article 1778, so a partnership of all present parties. So, kung unsa man tong property sa partnership nga karon-karon is that in which the partners contribute all property that actually belongs to them to a common fund. So, ilang intention ana, kay ilang yung i-divide yun. Divide-divide nila sa ilang kaugalingon as well as the profits which they may acquire therewith. So, present. Ang nagyod karon, lahi po itong sa future. So, in a universal partnership of all present property, UPPN naman ni siya, the property which belong to each of the partners at the time of the constitution of the partnership becomes the common property of all partners as well as all profits which they may acquire therewith. So, kana siya, katong sa universal partnership, kay tanan ilang property nga, kanang halimbawa, karon, no, today is September 10, 2021. So, nagmugna ako halimbawa partnership, D partnership with A, partner A, partner B, partner C. So, katong tanan nga mong properties, karon, as of this time, among properties, universal property partnership of all present property man may. So, i-appeal na mo ito tanan sa amo ang common fund. So, kato siya, common property na to. Common nga property. Halimbawa, kani among office, halimbawa, okay, kuan man ko, appeal ni siya sa kuang property, present property na karon, appeal ni siya nga may mong common nga property sa mong partnership. So, pwede mo gamit din ang akong mga partners, pwede rin diri mag unsa mga meeting-meeting na mo, ana, tapos kung naman may mga parent, ipalis ni siya amo ang office, halimbawa. So, katong profit nga makuha aning among office, akong opisina, even if I own this, no, wala gin ako ni siya personally, so, oh, part ni sa tong universal partnership, ang katong lease, ay katong rent, nga makuha na ako, ani, akong office, halimbawa, kay mabutang dito sa common fund sa amo ang universal partnership. Kay universal partnership of all present property man. So, a stipulation for the common enjoyment of any profits may also be made, but the property which the partners may acquire subsequently, so after that yun, by inheritance, no? By inheritance, legacy donation cannot be included. So, halimbawa, kay kanisya, universal partnership of all present property, appeal na sa kaning akong office, halimbawa, kay appeal man sa ako, ano, ako, I own this office, halimbawa, and then magiging common property sa akong mga partners, pwede sila makagamit-gamit ani, tapos ko iparent pa yun ako ni, ang rent, kay mga butang padulong sa common fund na mo, sa among partnership. Pero, kung halimbawa, later, karon ugma, no, ugma, halimbawa, kay nakakuha na din ko inheritance, no, nakuha, kay namatay, halimbawa, akong auntie, na ako na-inherit, halimbawa, or na-donate sa ako, na-delete to siya ma-appeal sa common fund. Okay, accept, except the fruits. Except katong, kung iparent na ako, halimbawa, ang ako ang na-receive via inheritance, then katong fruits ato, mabutang sa universal partnership na mo. Okay? Okay. Yes. Paspas kay ko, no? Pwede naman na pahinay-hinay, pero mulain na din ang tingog na ko. Okay, so we have here illustration ABC. Form UPPP. So, A contributed his only property and that's the specific car. Si B, contribute niyang only property. Katong yang yuta. And then, katong si C, yapong i-contribute ang yaharag yung property katong building. So, kanisya sa ilang UPPP, Universal Partnership of Present Property, no? So, ang ilahang partnership nga UPPP, mo na siya ang tag-iyaaning tulo. Okay? Siya na din ang tag-iyaaning tulo. Pati katong profits og fruits realized. Pero, kung halimbawa si C, naka-inherit na yun siya og another building, no? By succession, katong nga building, kay sira to. Dili to siya mabutang nga property ni UPP. Okay. Pero, kung halimbawa katong kanisya, kaning na-inherit niya nga building later ni C, katong yahang rent, ha? Padulong to sa UPPP, kay Universal Partnership man sila of present property. Subtan, walay mo tubag, of course. So you have here na pod kaning Universal Partnership of Profits. Now, in Universal Partnership of Profits, it comprises all of the partners and all that the partners may acquire by their industry or work during the existence of their partnership. So, movable, immovable property which each of the partners may possess at the time of the celebration of the contract shall continue to pertain exclusively to each and only the usufruct passing to the partnership. So, kani siya is profits, no? Klaro kay sa katanan nga, profits lang. So, ang ilaha lang makuha ni is katong, ang katong makompress lang sa ilang common fund kay katong unsaman ang abot sa ilahang serbisyo, no? Servicio or industry or work during the existence of the partnership. So, katong movable, immovable property that they may possess at the time, nga ilang pagmugna aning UPP, so, duara kapi UPP, continue ni siya nga sa katong partner lang. Dili sa UPP padulong ang katong ilang immovable property. So, ang katong enjoyment lang, kaning usufruct passing to the partnership. So, ma-enjoy-enjoy na nila, makagamit lang sila sa immovable or a real or immovable property, makagamit lang ang UPP, katong Universal Partnership of Profits. So, money siya, coverage of UPP, UPP lay po itong UP, nga tulo ka P, ha? Universal Partnership of Profits. So, all properties acquired by each partner from his work or industry. So, during the lifetime of the partnership. So, dapat katong time nga napa ng partnership, tanang properties acquired by each partner from his work or industry during the life of the partnership, makuan siya kanabitaw magamit nila usufruct, no, enjoyment ra na siya. So dili ang katong kuan jud kanang karisya, oh, included are wages, salary, professional fee, earnings in business trade and arts. So katong ilang hago, no, hago padulong dito sa Universal Partnership of Profits. Okay. So for the immovable property or movable property, pwede ka itong sakyanan, mga personal property mo na. So excluded are profits by lucrative title. So kung katong mga yuta nila, katong ilahang sakyanan, nga makuha nila by donation, succession, hereditary title, findings of hidden treasure, dili to labot. Tapos, ang katong profits pagyod nga makuha nila ana mga properties via donation, succession, hereditary title, findings of hidden treasure, dili pod padulong sa universal partnership of profits, even if universal partnership of profits ang ilang partnership. Nga naman, kaya kanilang ilang magiguan is, usufruct ng enjoyment ramani siya, no? At the time of the perfection of the contract of partnership. Specific yun, naka-indicate din nga at the time of perfection of the contract of partnership. So, katong profits nga makuha nila sa mga donations, successions, hereditary title, dili na padulong sa UPP. Dili parihas atong UPPP. Katong tulo ka buok nga ang profits, bahala pagkuan siya, asa man to. Bahala pagkuan siya kanang via succession, donation, inheritance, basta profit, padulong dito. Because, UPPP man siya, Universal Partnership of All Present Properties. So, naderyo, it doesn't accept the fruits thereof. Okay? So, na aspiration for the common enjoyment of minimum may also be made. So, this is permissible. Pag kay may man siya, permissible lang siya. May, pwede, but the property which the partners may acquire subsequently by blah, 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 blah in such situation, accept the fruits thereof. Okay. So, padulong na din ta dinhi. Okay. Doon na ta. Okay, we have here present property distinguished from all profits. So, sa UPPP, present property, title of properties contributed, transferred to the name of partnership. And then, it will become common property of the partners. So, pwede sila makagamit-gamit ato, mag-common property nila. Profits derived from properties will go to the common fund. Yan. And then, katong sa from all profits, katong all profits lang, dili siya tulo kapi kay duara kapi, title properties remain with the contributing partners. So, katong ihang property, ang title, dito ra gyud exclusive lang, dili itouch sa partnership. Contributing partners still the naked owner of the property, but it's only that profits that can be, or that will go to the common fund. Okay, 1781. So, awup. Parang ang pangit naman, parang ay, okay, whatever. Articles of universal partnership. So, it is entered into without specification of the nature of the partnership. It only constitutes a universal partnership of profits. Kaning ayup. Kaning articles of universal partnership. So, UPP lang ang may tabuani sa ija. Okay. So, kaning siya, no? Universal partnership, least obligation, okay? Universal partnership nature is not specified in AUP, so it is UPP. Okay. Murag less mangod ang burden mangod kung UPP, unlike sa UPPP. So, persons prohibited to enter into a universal partnership. Nagyapoy mga tao nga dili allowed to enter into universal partnership. Isa man to, those persons who are guilty of adultery or concubinage. So, there is no need for the conviction of these people kaning adulterer o kaning nakakumit o concubinage. So, preponderance of evidence is only required as long as nalang yung ka-evidensya lang na magpatunay nga nagkumit na siya adultery or concubinage, diligin na sila pwede mag-enter into universal partnership. Katong mga donations made by spouses. Okay, so halimbawa ako, akong bana, minyo pa man di ako, no? So, akong bana, naghimumig ang mga donation sa kaasamo, tagsa-tagsa. So, katong amo ang donation made to each other is void. Diba, void, dili daw may pwede maghimog donation. Nga lang, donate man ko sa kumbana, char. So, dili pwede maghimog donations daw. So, dili may maka-enter into universal partnership. Except for moderate gifts. Pwede na daw may makatag mga moderate gifts. So, this is for spouses during the marriage. So, since dili ganin may pwede, how much more sa kabit? Mas lalong hindi po pwede. So, persons prohibited to donate with each other. So, kato siya, bawal po din sila. Persons found guilty in the same criminal offense in consideration thereof. Kaling, it has something to do with adultery and concubinage. Yapon. And then we have public officer or the wife or some other person by reason of the former's office. So, halimbawa, ako boss ko sa isa ka office. Halimbawa, dili man ko sa kwan connected sa DTI karon. Halimbawa, boss ko sa DTI, tapos maghimo o kanabitang naghimo o naghatag o gifts or limba ato sa akong taa, katong isa ka client, halimbawa, naghatag siya gifts ako, then later, kay, so din may mga mag-enter mi og universal partnership. No, so dili pwede mi maka-enter ana because that's not allowed. So as long as kana bitong they are prohibited to donate with each other, then they cannot also enter into universal partnership. So kani sila mga tao, since sa balaod gani dili sila pwede maka-donate sa ila sat isa, so dili po sila maka-enter into universal partnership. So timo, ma'am, unsay rason kay kani mag sa universal partnership kay magiging common ba ya ang inyong property, di ba? Magiging common. So parang magiging common, parang nangyari yan, parang na-donate mo na din, tsaka ma-enjoy mo yung property. So bawal naman 'yon. Ayan. So haba-haba niyan, pare. Yan siya. Next page dayon siya. So, Article 1783. A particular partnership has for its object determinate things, their use or fruits or a specific undertaking or the exercise of a profession or vocation. So, mo ni siya una-una ni Moha, there must be an object, no? Sa nga ilang i-contribute, so determinate things. And the use, fruits, specific undertaking, exercise of profession or vocation, gina-contribute sa partnership. Okay, napasya mga style ni Nana. Then we have universal partnership again versus particular partnership. So, katong universal kay, as in, sobrang lawak, di ba? Yun, sobrang lawak, vague, indefinite yung object na ilang gi-appeal sa partnership. But for particular partnership, sa ngalan lang dan, particular yun, no? Limited and well-defined kung unsa lang ilang i-contribute sa ilang partnership. Yan, so, if spouses cannot enter into universal partnership, can they validly enter into a particular partnership? Kaya dili man sila pwede universal partnership or in the properties nga unsa man na sila karon, ilang i-contribute dito sa common fund, and then the profits, they will divide among themselves. So, dili po ba sila pwede maka-enter into particular partnership? Mo ni pangutan na, so what is the answer? Yes, and this is for the sex opinion. Kay kung dili sila maka-enter, dili po sila maka-enter po aning particular partnership. Kay common sense or daw, logic ra daw, not sure. Okay, so what to nenta din he? So A, B, and C form a limited partnership engaged in manufacturing customized camper vans. Kabalo mo ng camper vans, for example, na kay van, tapos si Moni mo nga na siya daanan, na siya TV, na siya CR, na siya kitchen. So naghimo sila na nga negosyo. So mo na manufacture sila customized camper vans. So si A, B, og C ang partners daw. Limited partnership lang. So si A og si B, they are general partners. Dayon si C, limited partner lang siya. Dayon, si A og C, naminyo man dayon ni si A og C. Oh, naminyo sila. So, si B, yan ang ibaligya dayon niyang interes sa kay A og C. Kaya muna siya nga, bro, mag-cook third wheel ani. Oy, ako nalang ibaligya aning duha nga magtiayon ni ako ang interes aning among partnership. So, is the partnership dissolved? What do you think? No, the partnership is still existing. No, it is not dissolved because spouses can enter into particular partnership but not a universal partnership. Dili man universal partnership kayo, it is very particular ang ilang engagement, no? So ilang negosyo po sa manufacturing of customized camper fans. So nagyapon to ilang partnership, limited partnership pagani na siya. Okay, so mo nang gisulti sa case in BAR versus Suter and CA. So this is L-25532. So finally, mo ni siyang scope or coverage of particular partnership, ha? This is the coverage. So we have here a determinate thing, the use of the fruit, specific undertaking, and then we have exercise of profession or vocation, and of course we have the last monumento. So mao na siya ang kanang sa ato ang coverage sa particular partnership. Ang particular partnership from the term particular, no, determinate yun siya. So use of fruits. And then, agad sila undertaking yung ginahimog, yung specific yun siya. So, there's also this exercise of professional vocation. So, mawala na itong noun-noun, Jod, in particular partnership. So, if you have other questions, for my students, please, do not hesitate to write your comments down below, or you can send your comments via our Google Classroom or our official Facebook group chat. So that would be all for tonight's online discussion. Again, it's me, Attorney Hani, and thank you very much for listening. If you have some concerns, no, you can always send your comment or write your comment down below para sa sunod na tong discussion ato na siyang matackle still under the law on partnerships. Okay, daghan pa man tang i-discuss. That would be all again, ladies and gentlemen, and I will see you in my next video. Thank you very much. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.